Hey guys, I'm here with a new video, and today I'm doing the Toys R Us exclusive Transformers Animated Rodimus Minor. Now, I'm not going to go through his whole bio, but since he is somewhat new, there is the packaging. He is Toys R Us exclusive, like I said. His galactic powers and abilities are that he is called the Chosen One by Seekers and Peers. He is the youngest ever honored with the Valor's Flame, and he designed his energy bow, this little thing right here, all by himself. He's special. If you look on the back, though, this bugs me. This picture here shows a very, very, very nice-looking painted black bow. Even on his car mode, the bow is black. I think if they had kept it black and not this standard kind of burgundy that he comes in, that would have looked fantastic. That black bow looks great, and I am very tempted to paint mine because that really does look great with him. The bow stands out nice, and it's got a nice color compared to this, the regular little color here. While I am on the bow, though, you can attach it to his car mode. There are two little slots right there, and two little pegs right there. You got to be careful how you peg it in. If you hit the triggers, the missiles will fire. The missiles fire very, very easily. Once you get it in place, it does look quite nice on him. Normally, I'm against the whole weapons interacting with the vehicle mode. They most of the time look stupid, but a Rodimus, it actually does work nicely. It does look decent. But pull that off there. This is the Rodimus that we all know and love. This is his classic vehicle mode, updated nicely for animated. Robot Kibble is visible. You can see his legs there. There's his head. If you look on the upper part, through the windshield, you can see his head. Now, a cool thing, though, you can actually open this up. And there's his noggin. I'm a sucker for this kind of stuff. So, once you flip his head around, you can have how Rodimus not only looking out, but you can have even tip his head up. And one of the funniest things that I find with Transformers figures is when you can have them where their heads are visible, when they can actually stick out in vehicle mode, is they can actually go up a little higher. A few things make me laugh as much as the image of Transformers. Mind you, they're probably really stupid in this fantasy of mine, but just thinking that they can only talk with their heads visible, just, hey, go going, guys. That really does crack me up, and I like that I can have his head visible as he's talking, but you fold it back in place, that folds up. I'm going to leave his head how it is, just it's easier. My only real complaints with this mode is that the windshield doesn't really lock in place. It's down as far as it can go. You push a little lower, you can see it fills that gap in, but they let go and it pops right up. Minor complaint, I'm not going to have him posed in this mode, but it does bug me a little bit. But a very cool vehicle mode, I do like it quite a bit. And for a quick comparison, here is his buddy in this wave, and these guys are the two Toys R Us exclusives offered right now, much like how Cybertron Ratchet and RC were the exclusives recently. Sure, how they all fit together, RC is still kind of crooked, but they all fit very nicely together. If you can find Ironhide and Rodimus, pick them up, most definitely. Now to transform Rodimus, because I've talked long enough. You're going to unpeg his feet right in there. And then this panel is going to undo. There's a peg holding it from the front, and the windshield has a little peg on the side. Just give a really good pull, and it'll come out. You can see that little tab there. That's a really strong tab. It holds it in very securely. But then bring the legs down. While you're at the legs, you can see there's a little tab right in the side there. So when you squeeze the leg, it clicks in place, like that. And then get the feet facing forward. There's that. That's what I can do for now. You go in the back, and you're going to unpeg the back section without pulling it off. I'm going to try. But there's a little tab right there on each side, and that's what holds these on. I say I'm not going to pull up, and I already did. That little ball joint there is a bugger. When the slightest tug of this piece pulls it right off. That one actually held longer than it ever has. But those are going to swing around. If they come off, of course, they are ball joints. They peg right back in. Now, with those out of the way, you can go to his legs, flip them around, take these little pieces here. They're going to slide up to fill in those little gaps in his legs, and the legs are done. Arms, you're going to bring them up some more. There's a little tab right there, and there's a slot on there. They're going to bring up and actually click together. I really do like having joints that click together that actually hold securely. It's a nice thing that we don't get too often. These do come off rather easily, to the point where it really does get annoying. But they're going to go right back on, so can't really complain. Open up the little windshield again. While you're here, go ahead and swing the engine around. Give a little push, and it should fold. It does take a bit of effort, but then you can reveal the Autobot logo on the front. As a nice little contrast, vehicle mode, he has the silver one that all the other anime figures have. On the hood, when he's in transfer, he has the Show Accurate logo, which I think looks a lot better. But once that's open, take the wheels, flip around. You can see there are little grooves there. The wheels don't really lock anything in place. It's just there for looks. And once you get it there, it is a bit wobbly, and that kind of had me worried.
Have no fear, though.
We got more tabs in the back, little slots to the windshield, squeeze that in. And it keeps the chest locked in, which is amazing to me for some reason. Spoiler flips up. Take this little piece here. It's going to fold down. That's done. It doesn't really hold securely. It definitely just rests. There's no massive thing there. But that's that. And there's that. Take the arms, fold them down. Take his hands, flip them out. And there we have Transformers Animated Rodimus. His bow, of course, fits right in his hand. It actually clicks in place, which is always a nice little treat. And a very, very nice figure. I am impressed by this guy quite a bit. That up there. And I'm going to get this out of the way. Here is Ironhide with him to show how they fit together. Here is RC. And since Earth Mode Prime is MIA, here is Cybertron Optimus to show how they all fit together. And his legs are, for some reason, bent funny now. Oh well. But they all fit together rather nicely. Rodimus, as you can see, he's a nicely sized deluxe because he has a lot of bulk for his upper body. Legs are really slender, but he does fit with the animated guys, I think, perfectly. And I'm just really blown away by him. I was really unsure at first. The first pictures made him look rather impressive. Then I saw some newer actual stock art, and I wasn't too impressed. Yes, his legs are very slender compared to his upper body, but I think it actually does work for this kind of aesthetic very very well. I like him. Crossbow fits in his hand. The missiles on it fit rather loosely. You have to kind of toy with it. It took, I want to say, a minute of just kind of finding that one little sweet spot where it would hold in place nicely. But they do fire pretty well. Pew! Pew! And I'll find those later. But Crossbow does look great. You can maybe see what I mean, that with it being the same color as him, it kind of blends in with his body paint. You can definitely see the bow, yes, but it does blend in. If it had been black, it would have stood out a lot more and would have looked a lot better visually, I definitely do think. But not too bad. Articulation-wise for him, the head is on a ball joint, so it has all that full movement. He does have a little added hinge there for his transformation, so you could have him looking a little further down, a little further up. Ball joints for the shoulders, but again, they are rather loose. They do pop out easily. You can swing them out about that far before they do get to that point where they will extremely pop out. Elbows on a ball joint, it can rotate. It has an added hinge for the transformation, so you could say a double elbow, possibly. Ball joint connects the wrist to the arm, so it has that full movement. The wrist can rotate. It's on a little added hinge for the transformation. Full waist movement. The legs can swing forward, back, rotate, all on ball joints. Knees can bend, rotates at the knees. Ankles are on ball joints, so they have a good variety of movement. And, yeah, just a very solid figure. He does have light piping in his eyes, so I don't know why I'm trying to pose him. But, get it going there, you can see the light piping looks fantastic with him. But ultimately, this is just a very well-made figure, and I would say pick him up. Since he is still new, him and Ironhide, I think are just now... Hello. I think him and Ironhide are just now hitting Toys R Us's. If you do see them in, pick them up. If they are not out there, find a clerk. Ask if they have any. When I went to my Toys R Us, the clerk was just now bringing out boxes and boxes of just Ironhide and Rodimuses. So he's out there. Just, you gotta look for him. But I would say pick him up. He's a great addition to the animated family and a very well-made figure. But that is it, guys. I hope you enjoyed this video, and I hope you have a great day. I will see you around. Take care.